Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. In this video, I would explain how to set up SSH server in Linux. So the operating system chosen is CentOS 7 or 8. In the diagram, I have shown two SSH clients and one SSH server. So in this video, I am going to show how to set up the server part. So in the later videos, I would show how to set up the client part. So SSH server would be installed using OpenSSH server package. So we have to download this package and install the SSH server. So when we install this OpenSSH server package, there is a daemon called SSHD which runs in Linux. So this listens for client connections. By default, it runs on port 22, but we can change the port 22 to some other ports as well. The port can be changed by changing the port configuration inside SSH daemon configuration file. And also we can enable different authentication methods like password, public key or Kerberos tickets, etc. In this video, I would show how to enable the password and public key authentication in the server. So let's start installing SSH server inside CentOS 7 or 8 machine. So this is the CentOS machine. Let me verify the operating system version. So here the version is CentOS Stream Release 8. So I would use yum tool to download the OpenSSH server package and install the same. So since I am using yum, same commands will be applied for CentOS 7 version as well. So let me download and install the OpenSSH server package using yum install OpenSSH server. So it will ask us to download it. Let me say yes. Now it has downloaded the required packages and installed. So the installation is complete. So when we install this OpenSSH server package, we also would get the SSH daemon. So let me start the daemon. Systemctl start SSHD. So the SSH daemon is started. Let me verify the status. Yeah, this is the status of SSH daemon. So here it is saying the server is listening on port 22. So by default the port is 22, but we can change this port 22 to some other ports. So let me close this. SSH daemon uses an important configuration file which is called sshd-config. Let me open that file. So that is present inside etc SSH directory. Let me open the file. So in this file, we can configure various options like changing the port or changing the listen address. So here we can change the port from 22 to other ports by uncommenting this, and we can provide different port number. And if we do that, there is a statement here. It is like, if you want to change the port on SE Linux system, you have to tell SE Linux about this change. So we need to execute this command. So when we need to execute this command, if SE Linux is enabled in the Linux operating system. So in this machine, SE Linux is enabled. So I need to execute this command if I want to change the port to some other port. It is also showing like host keys. So these are the keys provided to the client whenever the clients log in for the first time. So generally, when the client logs into the SSH server, then SSH server provides these keys as a fingerprint. That fingerprint will be stored inside a known host file. So that verifies the server authentication part. And here, authentication part, one important thing is permit root login. It is saying yes here. So that means we are allowing the root login from other machines. So generally, to avoid any security issues, generally we don't allow this root login. So for a better security, generally we comment this option. And it is also showing some other options like maximum authorized or maximum sessions. So these are the things like how many sessions are allowed at a time and how many trials for a successful login. And there is another option, public key authentication S. So this is commented out. So by default, it is not allowing public key authentication. So if you want to allow the public key authentication to the SSH server, then we need to uncomment this. Another important option, authorized keys file. So this file, like .ssh authorized keys file, contain all the public keys of the clients. So if any client wants to connect to this SSH server using public key authentication, then they need to put their public key inside this file. And also, if you want to change this file, we can change this file to some other file as well. There is another option here, password authentication, which is S by default. So that means it is allowing us to log in with passwords. For example, if you want to disable the login with passwords, then we can comment this option. And there are some other options like Kerberos options. So as of now, I am not doing any with Kerberos authentication. So I will leave the defaults as it is. And there are some other important options like agent forwarding or TCP forwarding. So which forwards the traffic to other machines. Generally, these are required when we forward the traffic to other machines while using SSH agent or some other forwarding types. So these will be explained in the later sessions when we explain the SSH applications. So I will keep all these default options. So in this video, I would change only two parts. One is the port part and I would enable the public key authentication. So let me change those options and save this file. So let me change the port to some other port. So I will change the port to 2232. So this is the port on which the SSH daemon will run when we change that. And also I would enable the public key authentication. So I would save the file and also I would copy these commands because I need to execute this because this machine is enabled with SE Linux system. So let me save this file. The file is saved. So I will execute the command. So here we need to give the port whatever we want to use. Okay, so now the port is allowed. So let me restart SSHD. The SSH daemon is restarted. So let me verify the status. Here if we see the status of the daemon, it is saying the server is listening on port 2232. So that means we have successfully changed the port from 22 to 2232. Okay. So let me close this. So to verify the connection to this server, so let me log in with some other user. So I will log in with some test user. This user is already configured in this machine. So I have logged in with this user. So let me connect to this server, SSH, the port number is 2232 and the server name is localhost because I am connecting from the same machine. So whenever we connect from the first time, so the server will provide the fingerprint of the host key. So this key will be saved inside a known host file. So if I say yes, so the key is permanently added to the list of known hosts. So that means whenever next time when we log in, so it will check inside this known host file about the server authentication. Since we have enabled the password authentication by default, it is asking the password. For example, if we and it is not asking public key and all because we did not put any public key inside the authorized keys file. So I would show that in a separate video how to generate the keys and how to put in a authorized keys file. Now those things will be explained in the later session. So as of now, let me provide the password. So now the user is successfully logged into the server. Basically what we have done in this session, we have installed an SSH server inside CentOS machine and we have seen what are different options inside SSH daemon config file and also we have changed the port to some other port and we have enabled the public key authentication. And one more thing I want to tell. So while changing the SSH daemon config file, we have to be very careful in production because if any misconfigurations, then it will be a problem. Okay. So for that, what we can do? So before starting the server, generally we can check the configuration. So we need to check the configuration using SSHD-T. So this will verify our configuration. So if it gives any syntax errors, then we have to correct them. So this is not giving any syntax error. That means our configuration file is correct. So this needs to be done. So generally what we need to do, we need to take the backup of the configuration file before changing. And also after changing, we need to execute this command to verify any syntax errors inside the configuration file. So this is an important step while performing these kind of steps in production. So this is all about this session. Thanks a lot for watching the video. If you like the video, please like, subscribe and share with your friends. Thanks a lot.